Well, it's been nearly 10 months since the coconut rhinoceros beetle was first discovered on Oahu at Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam. Since then, more than 2,000 beetles have been captured in traps and mulch piles. Well, today we got a look at a new machine that's being used to get rid of the beetles and also the mess they leave behind. Sarah Uro follows up.
The Hawaii Department of Agriculture says we're only in the beginning stages of the eradication of the coconut rhinoceros beetle, and it could take years to wipe out.
This is a very serious pest. It affects not only coconut palms, but all other palms. It will also affect bananas, pineapples, plumerias. So parts of what we know of Hawaii could disappear because of this beetle.
One-way crews are getting rid of the pest is by using what's called an air curtain burner.
The air curtain burner is basically a large incinerator. Any plant or green waste that may be infested with the beetle could be burned in this.
These are trees that were cut down on base, about 120 of them. We want to burn them before they're able to get infested. It's the best method we have of getting rid of the material.
It's quicker, it's more efficient, it burns, and then the residue that's left is almost nothing. You know, it's 5% of whatever volume we put inside. And so the ash is almost nothing.
Each air burner costs around $80,000. This one is owned by the USDA. The military also has 4 air burners on order, and the state ag department plans to order one within the next couple of months. The cost to ship one of these to Hawaii, about $16,000.
We'll have 6 of these machines on Oahu destroying materials that could be infested by CRB.
The rhino beetle has been found at Barbers Point and Campbell Industrial Park, but traps have been placed all across Oahu. State officials want to make sure it doesn't spread any further.
Just be aware of what this insect is and help us out by calling it in if you see something.
We've posted the number for the state's pest control hotline on our website, khon2.com. Sarah Yoro, KHON2 News.